The Uncle Mike Show is brought to you by
What's crack-a-lackin' Uncle Hood? www.theunclemikeshow. The Halloween edition is about to go pop, 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 baby. Well, finally, you guys see the final product right in front of you. A big shout out to my homegirl, Tenny, for hooking us up. Boom, check it out, boys and girls. And children of all ages. Apparently, this is Nike Monstar, baby. That's what we're representing. Nike just did it. Well, you know, when you finish doing every single thing that there is to be done, this is what happens to you. Thank you very much, Tenny, makeup artist, for not only in a short period of time to put this much love and affection into your work. You have to give her a try. She is an angel to work with. At 10 Platinum on Instagram. Check her workout, and her work speaks for herself. I want to welcome everybody from coast to coast to another edition of the Uncle Mike Show. At Official TUMS on Instagram and Twitter. www.facebook.com/The Uncle Mike Show. Last week, big shout out to my homeboy Mano Sound Machine, who came into the studio and we discussed a little bit about what he does, what his passion is, what his true love is, stepping into the studio and creating beats. If you missed the episode, very simple, get on www.youtube.com/coasttocoaststudios. Big shout out to Uncle Mano Sound Machine. The Coast to Coast is getting a lot of attention, and every single time I open my inbox, the lovely Jessica Sanchez from the Southeast Corner always has 6, 8, 12 renditions. Men, women, children. And I want to say thank you to every single one of you that have submitted your versions of the Coast to Coast. And tonight's Coast to Coast is brought to you by www.cleanevolution.ca. On-site drape and blind cleaning specialist. Clean your drapes where they hang. www.cleanevolution.ca. Well, this one here, it was our producer herself that got her eyes on this legendary rendition of our Coast to Coast. Are you kidding me? Kareem Abdul-Jabbar and Bruce Lee in the making of Ender the Dragon are seen pulling off our Coast to Coast. Jessica, you are an angel for finding this bad boy. If you want to submit yours, the Uncle Mike Show at gmail.com. Thursdays in the social media community is the Throwback Thursday. Let me just tell you guys, 3 weeks ago, we started this little hashtag TBT segment, and what we hear from you sitting at home on the couch, maybe even on your phone in the car, it could happen, man. 2015, baby, everybody's on the move. That's why we are very mobile friendly. I want to say thank you very much to our iTeam for that association. And this week's TBT is brought to you by ZestoPizzeria.ca. Come taste the zest at Zesto Pizzeria. 4343 St. Rose, Laval. 450-962-4333. But wait, there is more. Mention the Uncle Mike Show for a 15% kickback only at Zesto Pizzeria. All right. I've told everybody around my circle that if one day I had to submit a picture that describes what I do, this is the picture that I would submit. My homeboy Ryan Stevenson in the lobby of a hotel, right before he steps on stage in front of the VIP crew of Poker Stars. He is in studio for tonight's edition of the Uncle Mike Show, but that right there is TUMS Live with Uncle Ryan himself. Uncle Dirty Dur, my beautiful wife and I had the pleasure to follow him around for about 12 to 14 hours before the show, during the show, and after the show. And what I remember vividly is partying with a motherfucking rock star, baby, after the show was concluded. And you know, sometimes you say, well, you walk the walk. Man, fuck that. I was with the VIP, so I had a fucking walk in my shit. All this, if you want to catch it, www.youtube.com/coasttocoaststudios. That's where our archives are. The last time we had Ryan in studio, 57 Cals, our major sponsor, catered the entire event. The lovely Tamar was in studio. We had also the beautiful Karin in studio. We had Jessica Sanchez's very good friend, I'll call even BFF, my wife, in studio. In my opinion, that was one of the hottest Southeast corners to date. We're yet to match it, but we're working very hard. Don't go too far. When we come back, from the last time we saw Ryan to today, he has a lot of projects that he's been working on. He's made a lot of news videos. He's working on some new tracks. We're going to get inside his head. Ryan Stevenson, exclusive interview, coming up after these commercial breaks.
Hashtag I ask questions for a living, also known as the second segment, is brought to you by Le Calinour Educational Daycare, 3675 Dagenais West, Laval, 450-937-3920. Le Calinour Educational Daycare. For any information, 450-937-3920. I love the second segment. Why? Because that's where we make our money, baby. And tonight we are blessed to have a very good friend. In my opinion, someone that when he puts his sights on his goals, he does everything to achieve them. I met him as an internationally known drummer, but I am pleased to call him a musical legend, my friend, wow. Ryan Stevenson.
That's very nice.
Did you like that legend, the way I put it in there?
That's amazing.
Welcome back, baby.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
I've been seeing a lot of your work, but before we get there, how you been doing the summer season in the city of Montreal? Treated you good?
Summer season, that's clearly over.
Yes.
But it was great. It was busy, 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 busy. And summer's over, so that's why you put all these candies in front of me for Halloween.
Since he stepped into the studio, as you can see, there's a lot of empty candy wrappings right in front of him.
No,
it's all good. Don't worry about nothing, bro. There's a ton of them you're going to be able to get to. But there is a lot in the musical aspect that we want to get to. But before we get there, there's a couple of questions that came in. The first one is from Lisa in Vaudreuil. Since your last sit-down.
Dress up.
No. You don't need to dress up. We're all good because for the listeners at home, I'll be the one to mention it. He has very important meetings that he has to go to after. So it's not professional for him to come in déguisé and then try to go and be professional. But for him to take the time to come in studio is a blessing for us. So as I was saying, the first question coming in, from your last sit-down with Uncle Mike, do you have any new tattoos? And I hope we can see them, and hopefully they're underneath your shirt. Hashtag take it off, baby. It's starting off fucking amazing, baby. It's gonna be that type of show. I don't even know. It's 1 minute past the hour. Get ready, baby.
Unfortunately not. No tattoos.
That's where you grab your temporary tattoo right in front of you. And we're gonna try to find a place to put this bad boy on you. But is there any place left, bro? On your body that there is no ink?
She's mentioned under my shirt, but under other places.
Okay, guys, this is a PG-14 type of program. We usually go to XXX type around the 1058 mark. So just Sirah, man, we call it. Ryan's like, wait a minute, we got 56 minutes to have a good time. Two words. Hey, baby.
Yes.
Is this your new love?
Stuck in your head or what?
Oh, of course. Let me just put a quick story out there. Last night we're in studio, the beautiful Jessica and I were doing a little recon on Uncle Ryan and what he's doing in the last couple of weeks, just so we could be a little bit fresh. And we fell on Hey Baby's official video. And when we opened it on YouTube, it happened to be the 9,999th view. I tried to fucking refresh to get 10,000 because I thought maybe we'll get something, a prize, a special dinner with Uncle Ryan. Nothing happened, bro. I sent the picture. I go, 999. Do we win anything? He didn't even reply. But he did show up, though. We're fucking blessed. How fun was making that project, the video?
It was really fun. It was a different approach musically to some of the other things I've done before. Instead of being just bare acoustic or whatever, we had some electronic sounds in there. For the music video, just stayed local. Did it on the South Shore of Montreal. Some drone shots, some air shots that were really fun. Everyone just stops and says, like, what is that? Just mini helicopter that just takes off into the sky. Even I'm like playing guitar, like, where am I trying to sing to? Like, where am I supposed to be looking? Already that I'm blind.
For the listeners from coast to coast, we are blessed to have the opportunity to show you Uncle Ryan Stevenson's official video, Hey Baby, right now, www.com. theunclemikeshow.com. Official video, hey baby, right now, and we have the mastermind behind it in studio, our very good friend Ryan Stevenson.
Hey baby.
So, hey baby, that's what I've been telling my wife for the last couple of days. That's been the joke at the hey baby. Hey,
please don't walk away.
How much fun is it to work and break down this video? From the musical aspect, to the car, to the lady in the video, to the acoustic guitar you're going to be playing. How much fun is this process?
It's definitely fun. It's frustrating. A lot of work.
I'm sure it is, man.
I like being implicated in pretty much anything I do, so often enough, I'll plan it all type of thing. So let's say you start from just a demo, that then it's all the work put in to make it become, for example, the final product, And already, I find when I write a song or I'm recording a song, I already kind of have a music video going through my head. And I think that's when you know it's a cool song, when you kind of have images already, like, wow, this could make an awesome video. So I know it was just a lot of work to plan the video through. I'm a huge oldies fan, so I needed to get an old car. I had, like, nothing to do with any recent cars. Like, I had a lot of options. Like, it has to be from the 60s or
get me a classic, like, baby.
So from that to having, like, a chrome guitar...
That was nice. When I watched it the first time, I was like, whoa, wait a minute. I paused it. I go, is that chrome?
Yeah, it's chrome with a cool little, like, kind of golden inner body and some little details. It was awesome.
Is this yours?
No, it's not.
The guitar?
No.
Do you know where it is?
Where it is?
Yeah.
I was lucky enough to just borrow it from the store. So.
Oh,
so
okay. It's good to know people, baby.
Yeah,
it's
absolutely.
Good to know people. Off air, we were discussing the length that it takes to make a video like this.
I've done videos before that have taken numerous days to do. Often enough, I'll try to really just plan it strategically to get it done. This was, I'd say, like a 8 a.m. to 11 p.m. Just a full day. I just kind of scheduled where we'd start and the areas on the road to where we want to end, and then schedule the people of who needs to be there at what time. So at least I'll have, like, the earlier and the later moments alone, so I don't have to bug other people's days. I mean,
of course, you're trying to be as courteous as possible.
Everyone's always super nice and love being part of the project, but at the same time, it comes down to it kind of being my project. So I know that people don't want to sit down and wait for as long as I'll spend my days, because I just love what I do, so it can last as long as it wants.
The Ryan Stevenson Show, you started off as a drummer. You made your name. You've revolutionized the industry. And now you're starting something completely different. This is something that grabbing that guitar with your vocals, it's not the same game. No. I would say you are outside your comfort zone.
Absolutely.
But eventually, the more I watch you perform, the more I think, and tell me if I'm wrong, that you're starting to build yourself a familiarity. You're starting to be a lot more comfortable in your skin. Is this correct?
That's for sure. Because I find I jumped into... The project is something I've always wanted to do. I've always had the... Like, before drumming, I had the... Most people that will know me knew I had the dream of wanting to play like Elvis and play guitar and sing songs. Then I took the route of the drumming for a long time in my career. So now I just came back to one of the original things I wanted to do, and I just jumped in. I just jumped right into it without kind of, let's say, let's practice, let's get ready, let's do this. I just said, forget it. I'm just going, and I'll learn and build experience as I go, and as people are watching me, and they'll just feel closer to the project as well. I've kind of seen it grow, they'll feel more of a part of it, I find.
There is a little how do you call it? I have a little phobia, or I don't know if it's a phobia or whatever. After I finish any program, I watch it with Jessica, and I'm so hard on myself on any little stupidity. And for her, she says, don't worry about that. That's okay. Do you see yourself torturing yourself for perfection?
Absolutely. I'm like most people that have ever worked with me or know me know I'm really hard on myself. I mean, some people won't think that because they'll see some videos. Some people will be critiques and point out, let's say, things that could have been better in clips. So I could have been harder on myself and said, I'm not going to put this out. But these days I'm also writing a lot. So I figure if I don't want to put something out now to get it better, but during this time there's 10 other songs I just wrote, like, when does it end? Because every time you write something, it's always better than the last. So that's why I just kind of point something out, believe in it, put it out, continue, next. Sometimes things will come back in the future and will be great, and sometimes it's just like, hey, look what I did back then compared to now, and you can just laugh about it. You know?
Stepping inside a studio for you, what does it signify?
Fun times. No, definitely...
Do you...
Question. It's definitely many things. It's fun. It's knowing that you're advancing and what you want to do. Obviously, rarely you'll go into studio to waste time.
Yeah, that's why I never hear anybody, and we've had the opportunity to sit down with great musicians or people in the industry of music. When you go inside a studio, it's not to party. Mm-hmm. It's to work. And do you find yourself...
Definitely a mix of both, not to party, but obviously I like to work with people that I like. I won't just go and hire someone in studio because he has a studio. It's going to be someone that I know that I've worked with before that is as good as a friend as on the professional level, so we're going to get work done, but we're going to connect and communicate well, not just kind of like be bored and just down to business and not pleasant, because then it just makes the work not pleasant.
You were in studio on Thursday, and the day after, on Friday, we were very fortunate enough to stream your live event of the launch of your first album. I want to know a little bit about the launch itself, the party, how did it go to today? When you see your CD at Archambault, do you sometimes walk in, look if there's any, are these buying in 1 week? How many did they buy, these motherfuckers?
I'll go in and put it closer to the front or something. This week I was planning on, as a joke, taking a video of myself moving it somewhere better. And I get them. It's funny, it was on the top shelf next to like some other known artist, and I was just like, well, I didn't have to do anything. I don't get to do that funny video. Like, I'll take a picture, you know?
You have a lot of friends. You have a lot of family members. I want to know a little bit about the first day you launch your album. Talk to me a little bit about the types of text messages you got, the type of support you got from your friends, the funny ones, the ones that are a little bit more critical, the ones that were getting under your skin. Is there any type of story you could share with the audience sitting at home from coast to coast?
I don't think there is anything that interesting. I guess, yes, I'm lucky and blessed enough to have people supporting me and either just shooting good luck or... great music, great album. Where can they pick it up? At first, it was really just a fun project to have for shows, and I was lucky enough to get it in stores and at Chambou's and everywhere online as well. But unfortunately, there's no like juicy stories.
I apologize, Auntie Amanda, sitting at home in Dirio. She wants the juicy stories, please. Anytime. Thank you for tuning in. If you just joined us, this is the Halloween edition. We are going to talk a little bit about Halloween and if Uncle Ryan is the type that goes and does trick-or-treating at his young age of 22. I'm assuming you're still in
I just turned 18.
18, baby! Take out the brewskis, baby. We're legal, but not around the world yet. We need 21 for that shit. www.theuncomikeshow.com. We're sitting in the beautiful Coast to Coast studios with my very good friend, Ryan Stevenson. If you want to get involved in the program, at Official Tums on Twitter and Instagram, www.facebook.com/TheUncleMikeShow.
Tweet us. Go.
Go ahead, baby. While we were watching the video, we were very curious on the types of comments people would leave underneath your video, hey, baby. And we were not only surprised to see numerous messages, we saw a lot of love, a lot of support, but what struck us, not as odd, but I'm going to tell you because we are no longer just on a business venture. You reached back to every single fucking fan, bro, to tell them thank you. No, look, you're saying you have to. Not everybody does it, bro. Because you are humbled, you are down to earth. When we met the first time, I was starstruck. I was like, what the fuck, Ryan's coming, guys? What the fuck do I do? But then we were like, what the fuck? He's like one of the Oibes. And since then, we've been back and forth almost a half a dozen times, and each one was better than the next. So for you to reach out and touch the fans, I think it plays a pivotal part. Do you agree?
It definitely works out for the best. I mean, I think I just definitely... growing up or even now admiring or looking up to artists, and sometimes you contact them, whether it's a question, whether it's to compliment something, and then when you don't get an answer back or you don't have just an acknowledgement, it's frustrating. Still to this day, it's frustrating. You wonder, like, sometimes you wonder why, and people will think the artists are busy, and yes, it's a busy lifestyle, but at the same time, who would you be launching an album to if these people weren't there? Who would
That's
you
my
be
point, man.
Doing videos for if these people weren't there? So they take the time to give you views, to give you comments, to give you likes. Take the time back. I mean, obviously, there's a line where you.
Of course. Well, look, that's a very fine line because 2015, like you said, it's so easy for us sitting at home, you know, 450, 514, doesn't matter where you're from. All of these stars that we look up to, musicians, actors, actresses, sports celebrities, we could fucking reach out and tell them a direct quote. Do they see it? Do they not see it? That's all besides the point. Yeah. The industry itself has changed. Do you see the Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, these stuff helping your career moving forward?
It definitely helps. I mean, no one can say the opposite that social medias won't. I find it likely will slowly not help as much because people are just getting used to it. And instead of having Facebook that people are posting their videos and their shows and this and that, it just became so open to everyone posting the stupidest things on Facebook that half of the people are losing interest on checking their Facebook. So then sometimes someone will go more towards Instagram or Twitter or something else, but I find seeing it's open to everyone and people are kind of abusing what they can put out there, it's becoming less important for people. So
of course,
kind of
because
feedback
now
isn't the same as it used to be, that's for sure.
That's guaranteed. And we started to learn that. We're very blessed to have a great support cast that keep their eyes open on the trends and whatnot, you know? And what it was 10 years ago and what it is today is completely changed. That's why people have hired social media teams. Can you imagine how important it still is in our day-to-day lifestyle that people are hiring people to do this fucking shit?
A lot of
tweeting
people
still,
I find, pay attention and go and look up and see what they're doing, but there won't be that same interaction, whether they, because they don't think it's the actual artist or personality behind
another
it,
thing bro you know
to leave a comment, they'll just look at it, acknowledge it, but not leave any mark of a like or a favorite or a, I'm not sure what it is, but people for sure aren't interacting with it. I think it's just because how social medias have changed. In the moment now, you'll go and like someone's status, it'll pop up saying, hey, this person liked this person's thing, that people are like, oh, I don't want people to know I like this
you
guy.
See what's happening, bro,
so I won't like it, you know?
I never thought of, one second, taking notes right here. He's teaching us shit, baby. He's teaching us shit. Uncle Ryan Stevenson at Ryan Stevenson Official on Instagram. But if we jump on Twitter, that's my next question.
Yeah.
At RJWS
underscore
Henry. Oh, RJW score underscore. Yes, I apologize.
Because there's
Henry sitting in the 514 wants to know, what does RJWS stand for? Happy Halloween. Hashtag don't drink and drive. Thank you very much, baby. You can eat as many as candies. Are we keeping track? We should have had a fucking ticker. Ding. And it just keeps going higher and higher. And we should have had a number, like an over-under. RJWS, we have a fan. We'd like to know. What does it stand for?
Ryan James Willis Stevenson.
Boom.
It's very French.
And that is, do you remember the joke you used the first time we met in the old Quicksand Studios that used to be inside our, my wife and I, we used to, our basement, we turned it into a studio.
The same thing, I'm just repeating myself?
No, you said that was my good Christian name. That was,
really?
That was, yeah, that's what you said. And until today, sometimes when my wife uses, you know, when, you know, they call you sometimes baby, you know you're okay, everything's good. Sometimes she goes, babe, it's getting a little, but then when she says, Mike, now you know you're fucked, right? So sometimes I say, well, that's my Christian name. Can I help you? Halloween, a couple of days. Do you enjoy yourself on Halloween? Do you see yourself going to Halloween parties?
Not really. I mean, often enough, I usually, when the club scene was a bit more happening, there would always be Halloween events. I don't think I'd ever really dress up, though.
You're not one of those getting dressed?
Not really. But especially, I guess, when it was on like drums, even if I want to put some kind of makeup.
Of course, you're going to fuck it up.
Hot as hell on stage doing that. But No, this Halloween I'm actually going out with my nephews, so they'll be dressed up, but I'm just gonna...
And you're gonna be walking with them doing the trick-or-treating? And what I've realized is, because of the fact that the parents today are our age that grew up and loved this fucking thing, you know?
Yeah.
But our parents came from other countries and Halloween, what the fuck is that? Are you crazy? I'm gonna walk on the street. Shut up, sit at home. That's two different mentalities.
Yeah.
So what I've realized is, today when you go out and walk the streets, it's became a fucking event. Cops are shutting down streets. The houses are like... putting on music and there's fucking haunted houses. You could walk through the little mazes and shit.
That's fun for the kids.
Every time October hits, I'm not a big prayer, but I always pray that December 31st is a great... October 31st is a good day. You know, it's not raining or it's not snowing or it's not cold. Because seeing these kids dress up, they're living their fantasy in one way or another.
That's true. They're having fun.
Okay.
Kids usually always dress up and act like if they're superheroes. Kids.
Very important in this this phrase. Why? Because I'm about to flip it. Yeah, look. Right? But this is good. We're having fun. The suit said, listen, if you don't do what Auntie Tenny, the beautiful artist that put this together, if you don't do it, don't come back to the studio. So I was fucking frightened. So that's why I visited Tenny Sarkisian, makeup artist, and look at this beautiful figure that she gave me. My wife hasn't kissed me yet since seeing this, but I'm sure she's gonna come to eventually, you know. But okay, this message is gonna be a little maybe harsh, but I don't want you to take it personally because it's not visé contre toi. Okay, chicks today have taken Halloween as an opportunity.
So you're going to talk about chicks and you're telling me not to be offended?
No, because what I'm going to say, I don't know if you're... okay, kidding. As guys, bro, we love seeing what we see. Let's not kid ourselves, okay? But 10 years ago, there was a nurse. 2015, there's a sexy nurse. Back then, there was a doctor. Today, there's a sexy doctor. Back then, there was a Catwoman. Today, there's a sexy Catwoman. Back then, there was King Kong. Motherfucking chicks turned King Kong into sexy King Kong. Why do we have to take Halloween?
The hairy girls?
You're with the program, Ryan. You're with the program, baby. But do you understand where I'm trying to go? And have you realized that the sexy is getting sexier as we go along?
Sex sells.
Yes. Thank you for joining our program, baby. That was the moral of the story. Sex fucking sells. It does look good to the eyes, but do you think these girls, 14, 16, 18, are starting to push the envelope a little bit too far?
For sure. I mean, I guess what doesn't help is the artist factor that you'll watch music videos, and because of the reason that sex sells, they'll really push it as far as they can go, and as much as it could be commercial music, these people are looking up to these artists and following in those footsteps. I mean, hell, everyone does it. I mean,
of course, everybody does it.
On my drum remix, Addicted, I mean, I'm sure more than half of those views are the people watching it for the girl waking up in the bed and beside me in the morning. They're like, hey,
look,
who's this Ryan guy? I mean, drums, what's this? But
that's one of my favorite videos, by the way.
The Addicted one?
Whenever, you know, I'm like feeling in the mood, this, that, we're in the studio, we're having a good time. We like to go to the Armenian MC Cypher. And the close second we always go to is I'm addicted to, but the way you own those drums, bro. And that's the video that we watched right before you came to the studio the first time. Mm-hmm. So imagine, we're like, what the fuck? This guy's coming to the fucking studio, baby. Beat us up. And we have a pair of you've used those.
Of course, they're broken. So
I couldn't believe the... How do you call that? Fuck, man. I swear, I have to go back to school, babe. I'm telling you. I'm losing my fucking... my English, man. Bring me those things. What do you call that?
Drumsticks?
The drumsticks. Exactly, man. Give me one of them at least. Did you like your corner over there? We've dedicated the Ryan Stevenson corner right on top of the whiteboard. Oh, thank you. Of course, the CD also. signed to the Uncle Mike Show from my homeboy, baby. What do you think this is, man? We're not fucking around, baby. Right there, baby. Check it out. And right here in my hands. Look at this, man. It's all busted up and everything. I thought he was going to bring us a brand new one. You know, we're going to sell that shit on eBay. And then he gives me this. I go, bro, I can't sell it. This is fucking used. And then wait a minute. No, no. Used. It's fucking better, bro. It's been used by Ryan Stevenson.
Any ever since then, though, I got, you know, a drumstick sponsor. So my sticks are always better quality now. Promark, baby.
That's how we do it, baby. Throw that punchline in there. You're having a good time? You need anything? Booze, chocolate, Coke? When I say Coke, a lot of people always, guys, Coca-Cola Classic, the fucking drink. Why do you guys keep sending emails?
You know, I'm a clean little boy when I thought Coca-Cola, right?
I was like, oh. www.theunclemikeshow.com. We're going back and forth with a very good friend and a huge contributor to The Uncle Mike Show. Ryan Stevenson, don't go too far. When we come back, we got a couple of more questions coming in from the Coast to Coast Nation, and then we have our Halloween edition of Can You 60 Hickory Dickory Dock. We'll be right back. www.theunclemikeshow.com and Coast to Coast Studios is sponsored by 57cals.com, 1114 Boulevard Curé Labelle, Laval. For reservation, 450-505-8181. Delivery is available. Vegan is the new black. www.57cals.com. We are here live. www.theunclemikeshow.com with a very good friend, Uncle Ryan Stevenson. If you have any questions, remarks, if you would like to complain, because a lot of you mother like to do that shit, at Official Tums, Twitter, Instagram. We ain't hiding, baby. We ain't hiding. www.facebook.com/theunclemikeshow. Ryan, you're okay until now? Everything
great.
Copacetic?
Great.
For the audience sitting at home from coast to coast, I would like to know new projects that you're working on. What do we expect from Ryan in the 2016 time frame?
Too many things.
No, that's always good, baby.
Everything just from new drum shows, new tours, a lot of writing these days. Kind of in the writing phase, just to come new material. I mean,
is it fair to say that you're still drumming the Ryan Stevenson show?
Yeah, absolutely. Going to Europe in December for some shows.
You see the way I just let it up so you could talk about that shit?
Yeah.
I'm learning this fucking game, bro. I'm fucking learning this shit, bro. It took 4 years, but we're finally getting there. Fucking hey. How do you enjoy traveling and doing what you love to do?
I love it. I mean, definitely I'm born and raised here. Love traveling around the province and all that, but definitely love even more when I get to travel and you're kind of going branching out. It's kind of almost like a challenge because people will know about you or some will still be fans, but overall you're kind of back in that challenge of going to get them like when you first started, kind of taking the route that not everyone there knows who you are, what you do, and you kind of got to win them over. So it's not always easy because sometimes you're like, they're liking this. But
favorite city that you've performed in?
Should I say Montreal?
Boom! That's how you get the love from your own community, baby. Ryan, you see that picture of the of Montreal? That's a new skyline of Montreal from the South Shore. In my opinion, our city is one of the nicest cities in the world. It's a tragedy. I could use the word fucking tragedy because of the politics that what happened to our city. Mm-hmm. But my father says in 70s when he landed, he said it was booming. It was, people used to call it the Monaco of North America.
No,
people,
Montreal is great. I think we just, like anywhere, everyone takes things for granted. So let's say we'll want to go elsewhere. We'll go somewhere else and be like, wow, this is amazing. But no matter where you go, those people would love to come into Montreal.
Absolutely.
Like, I find we'll just take it for granted and like always complain about it, but we're just used to certain things and we've been there, done that, so we always want to go elsewhere thinking the grass is greener on the other side. But
that's the biggest bullshit, bro. That's one comment or one quote that I despise, because I think that's the biggest bullshit. Nowhere is greater than where you are. Mm-hmm. It's all in your head. It's if you want to leave where you are right now, it's very easy to make excuses to leave. You know what I mean? Anyway, a city that you haven't performed in that you would like to hit in the near future, where would it be?
I think I'd like to go to Australia.
Wow. Okay, I'm just going to warn you. Australia has the 10 deadliest snakes and the 10 deadliest fucking spiders. Are you sure you want to go down there, brother?
Got drumsticks and guitar and drop them. No, but I was supposed to go once. It finally got canceled. And have some fans that have been following me for a long time over there, so it'd be great to actually get out there.
My favorite question I ask all my guests, I've asked you this numerous times, I'll ask you once again. Where is Ryan Stevenson 5 years down the line?
Back on this sofa speaking about the last projects I've done.
I think he's been in studio 4 times. We've asked him the same question. He's answered the same fucking way all 4 times, baby. You know, when you're consistent, my man, you're consistent. And you mentioned something about when you finish a project, you start something else. Earlier on the program, I wanted to get to this point, but I just forgot about it. A lot of bada bing, bada boom, short-term memory loss. This is what they're saying. But hey, listen, Trudeau, he might legalize that shit, baby. You believe that?
We'll believe it when we see it.
Is it going to happen? We have no idea, baby, but let's see. www.theunclemikeshow.com. This is the third and final segment of The Uncle Mike Show. Jessica, are you okay today?
Candy,
Jessica, we never asked her. Do you have any Halloween plans, little senorita?
I think Uncle Mike is taking me a party.
Oh, thank you for throwing me under the bus. The wife didn't know.
Party.
Now she knows. Now the text messages are going to start. What do you mean? Where are you taking her? Yada, yada, yada. Ryan, what we're going to do right now, very simply, let's just go give the Unclehood members some time to stretch. When we come back, it's another segment of Can You 60. Your best score yet in studio is 23.
23?
Yeah, you think you're going to get better than that?
On how many?
It's as many as I ask.
Oh.
You think you're going to do better?
Let me get some more sugar.
Let me pop more of these bad boys. Jessica, it's all you, baby. Can You 60 is live, baby, right now. One-on-one with Uncle Ryan. 23 questions is what you gotta beat, bro. It's pretty simple. First, I want to say thank you very much for taking the time to come in studio.
Thank you.
Now let's put all the friendship aside. Jessica, are you ready? 60 seconds on the clock. If you're joining us and you are a new Unclehood member.
Started a bit late.
Very simple. We're going to be asking questions, random. Let's see how many can you answer. Or truthfully, one of our favorite mishaps. A gentleman was in studio with his girlfriend who happens to be blonde. We asked him the question, blondes or brunettes? And he answers brunettes. Unfortunately, they are no longer together. This shit happens.
That's why I answered both.
Cover all angles, baby. That's why we love Uncle Ryan. Jessica, are you ready? A quick shout out. Uncle Stefan Gagnon from Manson Design sitting in the South Shore watching his very good friend Ryan Stevenson and I go back and forth. Thank you for the love, big guy. Really appreciate it. Jessica, you ready? 60 seconds on the clock. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's go. What's your name?
Ryan.
How many tattoos do you have?
One. One big one. Hey, you're wasting my time now. This isn't fair.
I fucking love. Can you juggle?
Yeah, sure. See?
Are you a good singer?
Not really.
Are you a good employee?
Of course.
Are you a good skier?
Hell no.
All the women are waiting for this one, bro. Are you a good lover?
Of course,
babe. Me, that's me. What's your favorite food?
These rockets.
What's your favorite non-alcoholic drink?
Coke. Huh?
Wait, I was like thinking, wait a minute. Coke? Which Coke, motherfucker? Do you prefer sunrises or sunsets?
Sunsets?
Are you much of a gambler?
No.
Are you a good liar?
Yeah, whatever. Next. Liar? I don't lie.
I don't like, no, not me. Can you somersault?
I can try.
Do you prefer green or red grapes?
Both. I change week from week.
Porsche or Ferrari?
1960 Buicks.
Nike or Adidas?
I guess if I say Adidas, you're going to kill me because you're wearing Nike. But,
No comment. He didn't fucking answer.
I answered, but...
What's your favorite board game?
Fuck board games.
Fuck board games. That's what I get. I was waiting for the simplest answer. Monopoly, maybe. Fuck it, bro. Have you ever had proper... What the fuck is that? That's a zero question. Do you love or hate roller coasters?
Love.
What's the last DVD you purchased?
Holy mac, I don't even know.
Is that what we're going with?
Can't even say what it is. I'm just kidding.
Wait, that's it? I had one more right here. Can I go for it or what?
No.
Huh? Can you erect a tent? He got excited for... Tent, thank fucking God we're talking about
that.
This
kind of sounds like that, you know, like that tweet that you sent that people got you in trouble with. In the same ballpark.
So tent, yes, no, when you go, can you put it up or not?
I just sleep in the forest. I don't know what tents, what do you mean?
I'm a wild man, baby. Put me in the...
I would be able to.
Okay, not bad. Started off with 23. That was the number we're trying to get. 21, but I'll be honest... In a recent history, one of my favorite segments. That's what we try to get. We try to get an honest answer. We try to get a laugh here and there. Now what I want you to do, Ryan, very simply, look inside the camera that's facing right in front of you. And if there's any shout outs or thank yous or winks you want to send to any specific lady friends, this is the time to do it, baby.
Lady friends? I guess I can't give any specific ones. Get other people angry, or get people wondering who this person is and who that person is. So, shout out to all the ladies. You're all as important. I should stop there, I guess.
That's it. Wow, we're stopping right there, bro. We're just giving a quick shout out to the entire female entourage. Thank you very much. First, let me say thank you very much to our guest in studio, Uncle Ryan. It's always a pleasure to have you in studio. For the listeners at home, you did mention there's a lot of things coming up. Can you please let the audience know your Twitter and Instagram handles to be able to follow you and see what you do on a day-to-day basis?
For sure. The easiest way is ryanstevenson.ca. There's links for all of them because there's always so... complicated links, seeing there's many Ryan Stevensons, so I have weird names. Twitter's RJWS_, Instagram is Ryan Stevenson Official, Facebook, Ryan Stevenson, YouTube, all these platforms. I'm a social media whore, I guess.
That's what my wife calls me, bro.
RyanStevenson.ca is definitely the easiest way. That rhymes too, it should be part of a song. But hit me up.
There you go, baby. Slowly, we will put a sock into the Halloween edition of the Uncle Mike Show.
It's like mankind.
Before I do, I want to say the Montreal Canadiens they lost one game. And unfortunately, the city has already started in a panic mode. Are you kidding me? This team's future is in great hands as long as Carey Price is in nets. Bleu, Blanc, Rouge, the way they're playing with a few key acquisitions down the line, I believe they do have a team to make a significant run for number 25, baby. And now, first of all, let's say thank you very much to our entire sponsorship team. I want to say thank you to the lovely Jessica, who on a daily basis puts in her heart and soul that our program not only reaches out and touches everybody from coast to coast, but our feeds and links are correctly intertwined. I want to say thank you to Auntie Tenny from Tenny Sarkisian Makeup Artist for my little ensemble for our Halloween edition. And of course, you, the listener at home, without you, none of this makes any fucking sense.
Well, of course it does, but I mean, it just makes it more fun.
Thank you very much. From Ryan Stevenson Official to the Uncle Mike Show. Point your fingers from coast to coast, baby. Uncle Hood is... Thank you.